Hello, my name is Shauni Mukherjee, student of Liverpool John Moores University, Master of Data Science. My topic here is Airbnb price prediction using machine learning. Here we have used a supervised machine learning technique to predict the price of Airbnb properties in New York City. The data science pipeline which we have followed is data wrangling, data cleanup, data exploration, model building, which has been done after the pre-processing of the data, model validation, and finally the storytelling, which has been done after the entire data analysis and after the model building. The background of the study has been discussed over here in these slides. Every 10,000 people nowadays are choosing platforms like Airbnb rather than using the traditional hotels or guest house. Airbnb allows locals to share their residence to tourists. This has been a major trend shaping the global tourism. People are preferring more these platforms as they are getting a homely environment with a much lesser price. The entire hospitality and tourism service around the world has been changing and following these trends. The sharing platform were there earlier too, but due to rise of internet platforms and rise of Android phones and internet and laptops, these practices are growing on a large scale. As per New York Times, which has been found, Airbnb has been amongst the biggest player in short-term rental market. It has shown a rapid growth which turned residential neighborhoods into tourist zone. Despite the recent virus outbreak, the Airbnb has not faced any such difficulties. The aim of the research includes, the first was to predict the price of the property in NYC, which can be helpful for both the hosts as well as the guests. The attributes which have a significant impact on pricing, to find if there exists any relationship between the title of the property and the price of the property, and to of course use different machine learning algorithms and to find the best one. However, here we have discussed the machine learning algorithm which have performed well, and we have not discussed the one which have not performed well. Airbnb pricing is still a difficult task considering the amount of competition in the market. Also, the hosts, there is a need for to consider the number of features and amenities. It is shown that Airbnb loses almost 46% of revenue due to inefficient pricing of the listing. Further, there is also a need to study if there was any post-COVID-19 effects in pricing. Further, we have read different research papers and have found that the non-linearity of the data set has not been discussed. Few of the literature review which we have covered here are as follows. Research conducted by in California 2020 data, the general trend has been noticed in rental price on marketplace. To provide some reasonable suggestion about rental price, and later the host can make adjustment as per their need. A group of people found the graphical and statistical analysis was done in Airbnb data for Copenhagen. The research showed that variables such as room type, neighborhood, accommodations, bathrooms, bedrooms, and minimum stay have a significant impact on the target variable. Also, few of the paper used NLP techniques to find the target variable and if there exists any interaction between the target variable and the comments as a reviews. A variety of regression approaches have been done earlier, such as linear regression, k-nearest neighbor, random forest, XGBoost, ANN, and it has been found that XGBoost has outperformed all the machine learning models. Few of the papers also discussed ANN, artificial neural network, to find the price, since price is a continuous variable that which we are looking into. Hence, we are using a regression analysis to find the price. Research done in Seattle, 2018. The main aim was to find the relationship between the independent variables and the dependent variables. Here, the independent variables includes the room type, minimum stay, number of reviews, date, etc. The first plot which we looked into was the correlation plot. We didn't find much of correlation between the variables, hence there was no reason to doubt about the multicollinearity in the data set. However, we can see number of reviews and reviews per month are slightly correlated, which shows that if reviews per month is not there, number of reviews are less. We have also extended our analysis to 2019 dataset to find out if there was any significant effect pre-COVID and post-COVID. Here there is 2020 price distribution and 2019 price distribution. The one thing which we found was there was a vast difference between the minimum and the maximum during 2020, and it was lesser in 2019. There was a slight variation in price in 2019. However, the maximum price which was found in 2020 was $25,000, and in 2019 it was $10,000. Another thing which we noticed was few of the listings have price zero, which was an anomaly, as it is difficult for a hotel room or any rental property to have a price of zero. Further, it was noticed in 2019 and 2020 that the price was mostly in between range of $0 to $200, which makes Airbnb quite affordable for tourists. Here is the entire price description of 2020 and 2019 data. As we can see, the minimum of both the year was zero, which is an anomaly. And 75% of the price is between 0 to 200. Further, we discussed about the titles of the property, if they are related with the target variable. And it was found that few of the words such as room, bedroom, private apartment, Manhattan, spacious are the most frequent words for expensive property and were also most frequent used word for NYC Airbnb titles. As we can see here, Central Park, private room, studio apartment are the most used words. We made a word cloud to find out the most frequent words. The first model which was built was done without any feature engineering, and the R-square which we received was very low. The second model which was created, the R-square slightly increased as we did a feature selection and feature engineering, which showed feature selection and feature engineering as the most important part in machine learning models. And the best performing model was XGBoost, which showed R square of 82%. However, Random Forest also showed a very good score, but it was little overfitting the data. The main discussions from the research was are as follows. Through this research, we were able to understand the 2019 and 2020 data and the price distribution of the rental property. However, the research didn't receive any significant difference between the two data sets. However, we found that the difference between minimum price and maximum price is much higher in 2020 data. Further, the average price in both the cases were below $200, which shows that in an average, the properties are quite affordable. The significant features which we received were room types, minimum stays. Also, the result was in line with the study performed by a few of the researchers. One of the assumptions which is often overlooked was the residuals, and in a linear regression model, the residuals were normally distributed in this case. In conclusion, we can say there is a need to experiment with the artificial neural network and to find the best one which can outperform the XGBoost model. The present research does provide relevant insights. Overall, we discovered a very good number of interesting insights and relationships from the data. Each and every steps had been explained very clearly. Thank you.